Now we'll have a look at our officials for this fourth game. Bob Myers is the referee. The linesmen are Matt Pavlich and Randy Mitten. In the nets, Ken Dryden for the Montreal Canadiens. And making his appearance out here tonight for the Toronto Maple Leafs is Paul Harrison. Harrison playing in the nets. And Sterrell Sittler has gone to center ice with, and they do this quite often, they're using four defensemen. Williams, Turnbull, Quenville. And there's Scotty Bowman as we get set to face off. Risebrough at center for the Canadians. It goes back to Serge Savard, over to Larry Robinson, and Robinson gets it up at center ice. Chartrand knocked it over the line. At least get it back out. Sittler is checked. Goes back from Bob Gainey over Robinson. Back to Savard. Savard's pass. And Bob Gainey hits Risebrough and it was over onto this right side. And Williams takes it back down again. Shoots it in. Hutchison is up there on the forward line as the Canadians clear it out to center ice. Quenville lost possession of it, and the Canadians get the puck into Leafs territory. Play is called, and there's going to be penalties. From Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto, this is Stanley Cup 79.
Like an Alex Ovechkin.
Didn't take long, Gary. 36 seconds into the game, Chartrand and Hutchison goal.
Well, they had a little with the sticks. You notice Hutchison gave one and Chartrand right back again. And Bob Myers, he isn't going to fool around. He'll send them both to the penalty box. Keep control of the game right off the start.
Team's playing five aside as he's a point shot. Harrison knocked it into the corner. Oria Salming shoots it around on the boards. Lafleur is out there with Lemaire for the Montreal Canadiens, along with Brian Engblom and Guy Lapointe. Up for Boreas Tommy to center ice over the red line. Shot the puck in wide of the net. Rebound of Engblom. Engblom covered. Lanny McDonald handed it to Lapointe. And Guy Lapointe starts out. Perfect pass to Lemaire. Lemaire's shot is going high up into the crowd.
Well, before the game, we talked to Roger Nielsen. He told us about his goaltending problems and showed a lot of faith in Harrison.
Well, fortunately, Paul's come up with some very good games this year against Montreal. We were down there and lost 2-1 our last game of the season. He was outstanding, and he moved in the second game in Montreal and played really well there. So we feel really confident going with Paul Harrison in the nets.
And he's starting his first playoff game, although he played a few minutes in Montreal in game two.
Oria Salming, back of the net. Salming, being watched by Lafleur. Now he starts heading up to his blue line. Up it, he gets to center ice, had to go back. Lafleur watching him. Salming finally flipped it over onto the left wing. Robinson to Lafleur. And Guy Lafleur turns, gets it back to Serge Savard for Larry Robinson to Lafleur, and Lafleur turns again to Savard. Up it comes to Robinson. Robinson to Lafleur. He's over the line. Trying to get it through. He does. Lemaire shoots. Harrison stopped that and holds it out.
Gary, for late tuners in, I think we should repeat that Mike Palmateer underwent surgery today. They operated on his forearm, cutting a slit in the envelope, is the way they describe it, of the muscle in Palmateer's arm. So that came as quite a shock to get that news today.
Certainly did, and what a load on Paul Harrison's shoulders. You know, it's altogether different in the playoffs than it is in the regular season, and he making his first start this year in the playoff situation. I'm sure that he feels the pressure and is very nervous at this situation, but he'll get over that and get right into the game.
Pierre Mondeau out there on the center line with Yvonne Lambert. Quenville stopped partially by Mondeau. Gets up to Anderson. Anderson coming to center ice. Takes his shot. Dryden had to stop that. Up to Lambert. Lambert stopped by Anderson, who shot it to an open wing. Gardner going up to do some forechecking. And Mondeau missed Anderson and sends Ryler Robinson up at center ice. Over the line for Lambert. Back to Robinson. Back and front. Just missed by Mondeau. Anderson comes back with Turnbull. Turnbull couldn't get over the line. Now he passes to the open wing. Gardner sends in John Anderson. The Turnbull, his backhand is wide. Anderson didn't see Turnbull. Larry Robinson ahead to Rick Chartrand. Chartrand out of the play. Lambert and Mondeau. And Mondeau leaves the ice as the Canadians clear it back into Leaf territory. Now it's Turnbull. Turnbull. His pass at center, Risebrow got a piece of, and it's shot back in behind the net, but it's offside. Tonight's Stanley Cup game is coming to you from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. No score in the game as it's brought up by Engblom. Engblom bumped by Lanny McDonald, but in after the foul. Puck went to Pat Hughes, and he couldn't get it out in front. Turnbull now a pass to Williams. Williams shot the puck in. The reach for it. And Engblom makes the call for icing. Williams.
Moves in with Matt Pavlich. Talking to one of the officials about Williams and the way he fights, Gary, and he said, once the fight is over, Williams takes a very sensible attitude. He moves out. He doesn't try to carry on and move around and try to scrap again, although I've seen him do that on occasion, but they say he takes a sensible approach is what they called it.
Well, you'll see them both. Williams comes in late and puts LaRouche into the, or Risebrow rather, into the boards, and then they start.
Gives us a chance, perhaps, to mention that the changes in that Montreal lineup. Mario Tremblay's still out, along with Rajan Ouls. Jarvis is not playing, although he was able to play tonight and took the warm-up. Steve Schott, the Charlie horse last night, is not suited up, and Mark Napier, also injured last night, is not playing. So they've called up Dan Newman. They have LaRouche out there for the Leafs. Ron Wilson and Gary Monahan are not playing.
Well, you know, it's very interesting, Brian, that Montreal, they can lose two or three players and just replace them with players that do such a capable job, and that's the secret of their success.
Tiger Williams gets the additional two-minute penalty, so he gets 4 minutes in all, and Risebrow gets 2 minutes for elbowing.
Games. Harold Sittler picking up the new stick and coming back out on the ice.
See the blade on that stick, Gary? Sittler likes a big, fat, wide blade. No, that's not his. He uses a lot of tape on his stick. That's McDonald. He uses no tape whatsoever.
There it is, Brian. As we look down for the faceoff, puck goes to Harrison. He up to pass for Salming. Salming up for Lanny McDonald. Robinson takes him to the boards, and LaFleur has the puck. Teams are playing five aside. Guy LaFleur to Larry Robinson at his own blue line, up at center right. Gets over the Leafs line, trying to go around Salmon. Robinson gets it into the corner. Dave Burrows is there, and Burrows hits Lanny McDonald. Lanny McDonald, being watched by Lemaire, goes to Salmon. And Borja Salming up for Burrows. Burrows a foot pass for Darryl Sittler. Sittler over the line with a pass, and Lemaire has it. Jacques Lemaire with Guy LaFleur. Lemaire slowly coming out. Passed it back to Savard to Robinson. Robinson coming up to center ice. Goes over the line. Over to LaFleur. LaFleur then to Savard. Savard. Off the post. Back up for Burrow. A pass ahead to Darryl Sittler. Over the line for Sittler, and he's checked by Larry Robinson. Robinson stops. Over for Savard. Savard turns, goes to Larry Robinson. And a pass ahead to Savard to LaFleur. LaFleur coming down the ice, gets it out, takes a shot. And Harrison stopped that on the shoulder. Back up for Ron Ellis. That's center. Over the line. Ellis stops. Trying to get the puck loose. Canadians get it out over the blue line, and Jimmy Jones has it. Jimmy Jones, a pass for Turnbull. That's over his stick, but he pokes it and survives. Gets it over to Pierre Mondeau. The Leafs are shorthanded now, and the Canadians are making a change. Williams in the penalty box as Bob Gainey gets over the line. It's knocked back out again. Over Pierre LaRouche, number 28 out there, and the Leafs break that up, and it goes down the ice. Back forward is Mondeau. LaRouche is out there. Guy Lapointe. Bob Gainey. Long pass for Gainey. Gainey straight up at center. Over the line. Stops. Leaves it for Mondeau. He overskates the puck and it's driven down the ice. 1 minute and 14 seconds left in Williams' penalty as Guy Lapointe takes over for Montreal. A pass up on the left side. And cleared by Lambert. Into the corner. Picked up there by Karen. Trying to center it. It comes back to the blue line to LaRouche. LaRouche over for Lapointe. Lapointe in to Connor. Connor had the puck knocked off his stick and it's cleared down the ice. Up for the Canadians again. They have the man advantage. Over for Risebrough. Risebrough shoots and he shot it high. And it went up into the crowd.
You know, Ron Harrison really came up with a good save on LaFleur. And anytime he gets that puck and crosses that blue line, he's ready to shoot it. And here he unloads one. High shot. Catches it high on the block, or even may have caught him in the shoulder there, Brian.
Yeah, he shook that off as the play went down to the other end. And earlier, of course, Savard banked one off the goalpost behind him.
You know, usually when LaFleur shoots him, he's always looking for that outside post, just inside the post, low, just off the ice.
You know, LaFleur has an uncle in Thurso, Quebec, who's a staunch Maple Leaf fan. And when he brought the Stanley Cup back there, he kind of kidnapped it last spring and took it home to Thurso, put it on the front lawn. His uncle had his picture taken beside it wearing his Maple Leaf sweater.
On the faceoff, it comes back to Pierre LaRouche. Screenshot, and that's deflected wide. LaFleur left it for Lambert. Lambert with the score! Went off the stick to Paul Harrison, I believe, into the net.
Right chair, Bill. First score goes to Montreal. It trickled in off Harrison. Lambert tried to set up a teammate, and he scores himself. So it's 1-0 Montreal.
Well, power play goal, and Lambert just comes out from in the corner all by himself. And actually, all he's trying to do is dump it out in front. And hits Harrison and just trickles into the net. He was looking for
and there was right there. Never got
Jacques
the pass.
Lemaire, time 6:55.
I say it again.
Yvon Lambert from Pierre LaRouche and Jacques Lemaire, time 6:55.
Montreal's fifth power play goal of this series.
Yvon Lambert scoring at 6:55. Brings the Leafs back to full strength. Williams' penalty is eliminated, and Montreal leads by a score of 1-0. Here's Darryl Sutter now at center. A long shot into the corner. Out of the net is Dryden. He shot it around on the boards. Lambert left it there, and it's knocked out to center ice. Picked off by Dave Burrows to Pat Buttet, who was checked by Lemaire. And now Borja Salming back in his own zone. Shoots it off the boards out to center ice. Now the Canadians really flying. Come in over the line. Gainey a hard drive. And Harrison stopped that. Back for Salming. Up at center. A pass to Sittler over the line. Trying to make a play to Salming. He did, and he shot it high. And over the glass.
Engblom and Salming glaring at each other now. And we're going to have additional penalties. I think they're both going to go.
This is Stanley Cup 79 from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. And there we have the time to play, 12:25.
Let's take a look at the replay here, Gary. Slashing on Salming right there and hooking against Engblom.
Well, again, Bob Meyer's doing the right thing. You know, you don't want to get this game to get out of hand. Get him to play hockey, just send him off the ice.
Goes back to Quenville. Quenville shoots the puck in. The team's playing five aside. Goes to Larry Robinson, up to Bob Gainey on the left wing. Gainey coming through center. Comes to the loose line. Long turn to left stops. Giving it over to Lemire. Shot right this goal! Right on Larry Robinson's stick.
Timed out beautifully. Lemire to Robinson. What a pass from Lemire. And again, the Montreal Canadiens come off the bench. They lead it 2-0.
You know, the great thing about this play is Gainey. Ability once he crosses the blue line to hang on that puck. He doesn't get cough it up. He just hangs on to it. And then Lemire, what a pass to Robinson, cruising in, hitting that open man, and he just deflected it by Paul Harrison.
You might fault Harrison a bit on that first goal, but not on this one. Right in front, there's not much you can do about that.
You know, the Leafs have to always be aware of Montreal defensemen pinching in there and moving in towards the net, because they do it all the time.
The puck out over the Leaf blue line, and it's picked up there by Walt McKechnie. McKechnie over to Turnbull. Turnbull going up through center with Walt McKechnie. Turnbull trying to center, and he did. McKechnie at the side of the net. Cleared by Savard to the blue line. Quenville kept it in, but it's Robinson. And he nearly sent Pierre Mondeau flying down in the clear. Paul Harrison off the boards to Ian Turnbull. Turnbull coming up the center. Over the line with McKechnie, and it's cleared out by Serge Savard to center ice. Leafs come back. Turnbull over the line. Stopped by Savard. And Savard goes to Robinson to Pierre Mondeau. Mondeau, his pass hits McKechnie's skate, goes right back into the Montreal territory. Canadians leading by a score of 2-0. Here's Lafleur in the corner. Now Lafleur coming out. Coming up the center with Risebrow. He turns around and goes back. And he hits Guy Lapointe, and Lapointe just flips the puck in. Lafleur leaves the ice. Risebrow remains out there with Lambert, who slams into Ellis. Now then, number 24, Gilles Lupien and Guy Lapointe are the defensemen. Goes over to Lambert, back to Lupien. Lupien's pass for Risebrow over near him. Cleared in by Burroughs, and Dryden loved it, even though it wasn't on the net. Lupien, pass to Lambert. Up it comes to Risebrow. Over on the to Engblom, and Boreas Salming breaks that up, and he comes back at the point. Over the line, trying to go around the defense. Poke check by Lupien. Canadians nearly got it loose. As they, now they have it again. Lambert. A pass to Lemire. Lemire over the line with Chartrand. Came in front of the net, and Boreas Salming's back to get it. 9:57 remaining in the first period. Montreal has a 2-0 lead. And that goes down the ice and will be brought back for Aces.
You know, Montreal is so tough when they have that lead, because all they're doing is throwing that puck around, and then Toronto, they're just chasing.
With the score, Montreal 2, Toronto nothing. This is Stanley Cup 79. Laps, Montreal leading 2-0. Paul Gardner out there now at center with Rocky Saganek. The puck came back, a shot, that's wide of the net. Teams at full strength, of course. Boreas Salming gets it up for Williams. Williams, a long pass for Rocky Saganek. Saganek tried to go over the line, is broken up. Brought back by Pierre LaRouche. Gave him a good body check. Back and down the ice for Rocky Saganek. He centered it right across the goal mouth. There's nobody there. Canadians come back. Down the ice for Pat Hughes. He's over the line. Pat Hughes trying to get around Salming. Try to put it out in front. Gardner to Saganek. And it goes right to Guy Lapointe. Over it goes to Engblom. Engblom watched by Gardner. Gardner Williams takes his shot. That was stopped by Dryden. And it's Guy Lafleur over for Bob Gainey. Missed the body check. Saganek for Gardner. Gardner over it goes to Burroughs. He just shoots the puck in, and Gainey goes after it. Bob Gainey gets a pass ahead. Here they come. The Canadians at center with Lemire. A long shot off the board. The third went after Rogers. Got it to Gaines. Right in front to Lemire. And his shot hit a skate and deflected wide. Now here's LaFleur with it again. Guy LaFleur. His pass. Gainey couldn't get it. LaFleur's got it again. Over the line outside.
Lemire had a little trouble getting out in time, but again, great power by the Montreal Canadiens. They've outshot Toronto 6-2. The Canadiens have won 6 out of 10 faceoffs.
Brian, the Canadiens are very seldom anywhere. Are they shooting the puck in the Toronto zone? What they're doing now, they just keep passing it around, carrying it in, and making the good play. So when they're in trouble, they're not letting Toronto control it. They're chasing. That's all they're doing the whole night now, is chasing the puck.
Puck goes to Ian Turnbull. Turnbull back of the net, now starts up for the Maple Leafs. The pass at center, gets intercepted by Lemire, just shoots it right back in again. Back is Quenneville. Quenneville covered by LaFleur, but Lanny McDonald gets it out. Lemire is right there. Shot it right to Lanny McDonald. Oh, and Lanny McDonald got the puck over the glass. And we'll have a faceoff.
There's Lanny McDonald, 43 goals in the regular season, scored his 20th playoff goal like that last night. You're right about the chasing part, Gary, and also the Leafs have not come out hitting tonight. Borya Salming leveled one Montreal Canadian, LaRouche, I believe it was, with the best body check, and they're coughing up the puck a little too much to the Canadians.
Well, Brian, it has to be awfully difficult to go at the pace that the players were at last night. You know, I don't think they have very much left.
Tobias Robinson. Ahead to Doug Risebrow. He gets it over for Chartrand, and Anderson gets it for the Leafs. Anderson back of the net. Comes out on the right wing, stopped by Bob Gainey, who seems to be all over the ice, and it goes back of the Leaf goal again. Risebrow up there. Now it's Turnbull trying his luck. Long pass, and there's Gainey again. Bob Gainey then losing to Lanny McDonald, who finally gets the puck into Montreal territory. Here's Savard. For Larry Robinson, around to Bob Gainey. Risebrow is in the clear. If he can hit him, then he missed. Goes all the way to Harrison. Gets up slowly. Back for Turnbull. Takes a shot. And Dryden had difficulty with that. Alan Lambert, it comes loose. Shot it wide. Lanny McDonald blasted one wide. Canadians shoot it down the ice, and that'll be icing. He just missed by an inch.
But you know what? You think goalies don't like to throw a check once in a while? Just watch this check by Harrison behind the net on Risebrow. Just gets rid of the puck, and then hello.
Uh-oh. That stings.
This Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from Maple Leaf Gardens. Loses the draw to and Engblom clears it around on the boards. Shot down the ice again by Montreal. That was off the stick of Pat Hughes, number 30, and they'll bring it all the way back into Montreal territory, right?
Bill, our director, Ron Harrison, did a great job. We took him by surprise last night, or tried to. I'm looking for a guy in a fancy hat in the crowd. Now, men don't wear hats too often these days, but we don't want Punch Imlach. No, we've had him too often. We'll give you a moment or two to catch a guy in a peculiar hat. There he is right there. Look at that. That's quick work. What was the time there, Gary? 2.5 seconds? No more than that.
There's a bitter man. The puck comes out over the blue line up at center ice. Goes over for Maloney. And he's just shot it back into Montreal territory. Now it's around on the board. Comes up to center ice. Goes by Burrow. That's over the red line again. It's waved off by linesman Matt Pavlich. 6:04 to go in the first period. Goes back to Burrows. Burrows over to Salming. Salming at center ice. Now it's cleared over here on the right side, and Pat Hughes just shot the puck in. Salming will try to bring it out. He's covered by Lambert. The puck comes out. Guy Lapointe is checked by Salming. Engblom then recovers for Montreal. Gets it ahead to LaFleur. LaFleur coming down the ice. Gets the shot off the post. LaFleur wrapped that one off the post. Puck is shot back in again as Montreal change on the go, and so are the Leafs. The Canadians are really flying in this first period. Lafleur ahead to LaRouche. Over the line. Dropped it back. Here's the chance. And Cam Connor gets it back to the blue line. There's Savard. Back to Connor. Back to Lafleur. He Lafleur back to Savard. Savard took a shot. Oh, that bounced off the post on the deflection. Lafleur after it. Hutchison trying to get it out. He does to center ice. Lafleur is right back there to get it again. They give Guy Lafleur a real good hand for a great effort. Pat Boutette for Jones, intercepted by Savard. Savard gets it back to Larry Robinson. Larry Robinson going to center, gets it over the line. Larry Robinson centered it out in front. Here's back to Savard. Savard still has it. Savard coming out. Now he goes to the side. Back it comes to Gainey. Gainey's shot deflected. Harry Butler's got it. Coming up the ice. Over to Pat Boutette. Over the line to Jerry Butler, and he shot it wide. Pat Boutette for Jerry Butler. Canadians bring it back out, but they'll have a penalty. Live from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto, the Stanley Cup playoffs.
The man advantage to get back into the hockey game. They trail by two, and there have been three goalposts hit behind Harrison. There's the hook on Butler that sent Chartra off.
Brian, Toronto, they have to get something going, and one good way is getting a goal, get some enthusiasm going here for them.
It goes back to Turnbull from the faceoff. Over onto the right side to Lanny McDonald. He drives it in. Dryden stopped it. Fell down, and Guy Lafleur just shoots it down the ice. Harrison leaves the puck there for Boreas Elmy. Left there with Turnbull, Sittler, Gardner, and McDonald. Boreas Elmy moving to his own blue line. Gains momentum, goes to Sittler. Sittler shoots the puck in. Lafleur is back there again. Around it goes for Lambert. Lambert knocks it out. Savard shooting it over onto the left wing to Jacques Lemaire. And Lemaire dragging the puck. Got it to an open wing, and Lanny McDonald turns. 1:15 left in the penalty. A long pass for Gardner. Oh, Gardner. Goes to Selmy. Selmy then to Sittler. Sittler hit the referee, and the puck taken by Savard and shot around on the boards. Taken by Lemaire, and Lemaire hits Lambert, and Lambert has the puck. Over to Jacques Lemaire. Lemaire. Back it goes to Guy Lafleur. Over to Larry Robinson. Up it comes to center. Taken by Lemaire offside. And the faceoff comes back inside the blue line.
Let's go downstairs now to Dave Hodge. In our first intermission, I'll be talking to the hero of last night's game, Cam Connor of the Canadiens. We'll introduce you to the mother of the Leafs, Pat Boutette, and Howie Meeker will have highlights of a period dominated thus far by the Canadiens. All right, look forward to hearing from Cam Connor, last night's hero.
Over the line for Burroughs. He drops it back for Maloney. Maloney shot it into the corner to Robinson. It passes stop, but it came out in front, and it's cleared out by Bob Gainey. A race for the puck. After it is Risebrow. Risebrow taken out of the play by Quinville, and it's Dave Burroughs over to Walt McKechnie. 18 seconds left in the penalty at two Quinville, and it's batted point out and down the ice. Walt McKechnie, a pass to Burroughs. Burroughs for Maloney, that one over his stick, and the Canadians all over the Leafs, even though they're short-handed. Now they have Chartrand back out. Quinville, a long shot, that was deflected. Then Maloney's shot on goal, and Dryden holds it out.
You know, Dryden talked to me before the game, Gary. He talked about Palmateer, and he said, aside from Palmateer's immense skills, he really represents the personality of the Toronto Maple Leafs. They have a lot of leaders. He's certainly one of them. Leafs didn't get a shot during that power play.
You know, it has to be very frustrating for the Leafs. You know, even when they do get in the Montreal zone, they'll get one shot on net, and then it's out. They just don't seem to be able to get a concentrated attack going, which is so very important.
The draw. The puck cleared out to center ice. Hila Fleur couldn't get it. It goes back to Larry Robinson. Larry Robinson back at the net. Now he starts out. A long pass up at center. Ends up at the Leaf defense and Burrows. To Quenville. Back to Boutette. Pat Boutette shot one. Larry Robinson nearly directed it in his own net. The puck kept in by the Leafs and then knocked out again. Back up for Pierre Mondeau. Mondeau shot one. Look out, that's high. Into the crowd.
You know, another thing, Brian, is that you just watch the Canadians out there. As soon as their defensemen get the puck, the forwards are always making those little circles around the blue line. And when they accept the pass, they're in full speed, never standing still. And that's why they're able to beat a checker.
Well, we've got a minute 15 left to play in this first period. It's certainly been all Montreal's period.
Ian Turnbull, a pass for Pat Boutette. That stopped. Chetra shoots it right back in again. Oriasalmi kicks it with his skate. McKechnie, a long pass up on the right side for Rocky Saginac, and it's back over the line. Pat Connor was hit by Oriasalmi. Turnbull then bumped into McKechnie. Now a pass ahead to Ron McKechnie. Rocky Saginac back to McKechnie, and he couldn't control it. Montreal with the puck bouncing over to Oriasalmi. Salming is knocked down. And it's Guy Lafleur coming down the right side. McKechnie trying to stop him. He hauls him down, and there's going to be a penalty there to Walt McKechnie for hooking Guy Lafleur.
Now you'll see Guy Lafleur putting on that burst of speed, and McKechnie is just tapping him to begin with, and then right at the dot there, he hauls him down.
Lafleur trying to ward him off with the right arm unsuccessfully, and finally I think he grabbed McKechnie's hockey stick.
For hooky. Time 19:32.
Well, you know, there's still plenty of time for the Leafs. You've got two periods plus a few seconds left, but it's important that they don't get another goal scored against them in this last 28 seconds.
Guy Lafleur has gone over to the Canadian bench to get a new stick. Now he's coming back. All set to go. Puck was dropped, but we had Yvon Lambert inside the rim of the circle. It's Lemaire, Lambert, and Guy Lafleur as the point took a shot. That was taken by the Leafs and cleared down the ice by number 17, Jerry Butler. Back for it is Serge Savard. Savard with 11 seconds. A pass to Guy Lapointe. Lapointe coming at center. A long shot. Harrison stopped that. 3 seconds left. Comes back to Lapointe, and before he could shoot, the bell goes to end the first period. And Montreal leading 2-0. And the summary of the first period, Lambert from LaRoche and Lemaire at 6:55, Robinson from Lemaire and Gainey at 7:57. Shots, Montreal 7 and Toronto 5. And there's Paul Harrison talking to Boreas Selming as the Leafs trail 2-0 and also have a man in the penalty box for the next minute and 32 seconds, Walt McKechnie. His penalty coming at 19:32 of the first period. All set to go. The puck goes back to Boreas Salming. Salming shoots it right at Robinson, and Robinson has it for Montreal. Over to Lapointe, to Lafleur. Lafleur up through center, over to Yvon Lambert. Lambert shoots it off the boards, hit the back of the net, curls, drives it down the ice. And Dryden leaves it for Robinson. Robinson. Pass straight ahead to Lemaire. Jack Lemaire coming up at center. Gets over the line. A pass to Lambert, and it's offside.
Minute or two left in the penalty time, and another game in this series, if necessary, will be played Tuesday, April 24th at Montreal.
Now Lemaire, Lafleur, Lambert, Robinson, and Guy Lapointe for the Montreal Canadiens. Puck taken by Boreas Salming, lost it to Lambert, who ran into the linesman, Jimmy Jones. The pass over for Jerry Butler. Butler stops and flips it in behind the net, and it's given to Larry Robinson. Larry Robinson, long pass up for Lafleur. Lafleur over the line, Burroughs trying to control him, and does, and the puck is cleared out by Jerry Butler down the ice. Guy Lapointe over for Larry Robinson. 27 seconds left in the penalty. Larry Robinson over the line to Lafleur, offside.
Gary, while we have a second, what happened now in that Leaf dressing room? You've been in there before. What would go on while they're trying to get themselves back together?
Well, Brian, I'm sure every player had their heads down, and, you know, it's a terrible feeling when you're down 2-0 and the possibility of losing four straight games, and that stays with you the whole summer. So in that situation, it's up to your leaders, you know, guys like McDonald, Sittler, Salming, Williams. Get some enthusiasm in the dressing room and just remind everybody, guys, we're not going to quit. We're going to go fighting right down to the final whistle. If Montreal beats us, fine, but there's no way that we're going to, you know, quit on them, on ourselves. Let's keep working.
Puck is shot down into Leaf territory by the Canadians, and that's icing. And Hutchison.
Goal post hit. Four for Montreal, now one for the Leafs here, Gary.
Right, Brian, and you think after a game the goaltenders don't remember the ones that hit the post? You betcha they do.
12 minutes exactly remaining in the second period. Montreal leading 2-0. Gardner with Saganuk and Williams. Puck taken by Ian Turnbull. Lost it. Here the Canadians in front of backhand. Miller shot. They score! Up.
Well, you can't keep coughing up that puck in your own zone with the Canadians standing around, and they just capitalize on a mistake.
Well, that came right off the faceoff, Mondu. And again, the team spirit of the Canadians evident as Turnbull had trouble getting the puck out. Here it is. The first shot is a rebound off the glove of Harrison. He just couldn't hold on. There's the puck slipped in behind him.
Assist number 30.
It's just good checking here. Taking the man, getting in front of him. Second man going for the puck.
From Pat Hughes.
And then getting the rebound, slipping it home. But it takes all three guys on the line to do the job.
There's Pat Hughes with it again. Back to Savard. And it comes over to Larry Robinson, up for number 20, Cam Connor. It's over the line again. Hughes took a shot, and that was wide. Puck grabbed up by McKechnie. McKechnie in the corner. Comes out in front of his own net. Mondu watching him. Shot up over the blue line, but Robinson was there. Now then, Dan Maloney. He's stopped by Connor. And it goes back to Larry Robinson. Robinson straight down center. And he blasted one wide of the net. McKechnie. Now coming out with a long pass. Maloney couldn't control it. And it's Sir Savard, back of the net. Into the corner. Off the boards to Yvon Lambert. Lambert knocks it down the ice. Salming goes back for it. Comes around on the boards to Dan Maloney to Walt McKechnie, and it hit a skate as the Canadians are all over the Maple Leafs at this stage in the game. They're covering their checks. The puck goes in. After it goes Lafleur and Salming. Salming trying to get away from Lafleur. Down he goes. It's cleared out and then down the ice. Maloney goes after it. Dryden lets it go. Against the Maple Leafs.
Gary, let's go back to that goal for a minute. If the Leafs have been able to score and make it a 2-1 game, then it's a new hockey game, because then they get some zip and some zest and some things going. But when they get down by three, it's really hard to dig deep for that extra push you need.
Well, look at there. You have two Canadians in front of the net, defense out of position, and, you know, there's just so much Harrison can do. But it's very frustrating when somebody's on you all the time, you know, to, again, generate any kind of offense. And the further you get behind, the harder it is, especially with Montreal, because they just keep right on going. And they can smell victory.
Lambert against Pat Poutette. It goes back to Ian Turnbull. Turnbull back of the net. Turnbull then gives it on the wing to Hutchison. Hutchison with a pass for Jerry Butler. Goes around back of the Canadian goal. He rolls it up for Lafleur off his skate to Lemaire. Lemaire going down over on the right side. Lambert trying to catch him. He's shot by Lemaire. And that was stopped by Harrison. Comes back to Lapointe. Lapointe, another shot. Harrison just saw it at the last second. Turnbull gets it up to Pat Poutette. Pat Poutette to Jimmy Jones. And it's offside, Jerry Butler.
Jimmy Jones took one off the back of the leg earlier in the game, and those really sting. There's really not too much protection back there, Gary, is there, in the shin pad, although they've made them a lot better than nowadays than they used to.
Well, there's a little bit of felt padding, but mainly it's just sock. That's why, you know, make sure you face the shooter at all times. But when your old man hits you, it's tough to take.
Up the ice now comes Engblom. Engblom knocked it into the corner. He goes up after it. The puck is loose. They're trying to kick at it. After Salmi gets his skate on it and play his call.
You have to wonder, is this man coaching his last game behind the bench of the Toronto Maple Leafs? Time will tell. 9:37 to play. Speaking of time in this second period.
Well, you know, when you're playing a team like Montreal with all the firepower that they have and the way they can skate, it's a tough task anytime you play against them. Remember when they beat us out four straight? You know, the games were close, but the bottom line is we lost.
Bob Gainey flips it over. There's the point right in front of the net for Mondo.
Playing a standout game for Montreal tonight. They're ahead by four now. The game turning into a bit of a rout as Montreal clicks twice here in this second period.
Well, Brian, here's a good example of what you can do when you throw that puck around. The puck just moves faster than you can skate with it. And just a good, great give and go and open net. Nice to watch. But the Canadians, they have a habit of getting in good position and making their chances count.
That's his first career playoff goal. Pat Hughes making it 4-0, Montreal in front of Toronto.
Gary, I think Bob Gainey has played a stupendous game.
The whole series, though.
That's right. So we have Boreas Salmi now with the puck, getting it over to Burroughs, up for John Anderson. Anderson coming out of the Canadian line. Center to get to Sittler. Sittler couldn't get a shot. Sittler's got it again. The line McDonald was shot wide. Rick Shytrov over behind the net. Around for Boris. Boreas Salmi kept it in. Now it goes to Larry Robinson. He's jammed by Anderson. Robinson then comes up with it. And he shot it down the ice for Dougie Risebrow, but it's going to be touched by Burroughs. Icing is the call. With the score, Montreal 4 and Toronto nothing. This is Stanley Cup 79. Well, here you see the two coaches, Roger Nielsen and Scotty Bowman. Looking at their faces, you wouldn't know who was ahead. But Montreal is 4-0. 6 minutes and 19 seconds and counting. A shot off Anderson. Goes over to the far wing. And back to Hutchison. A shot. Another stop by Dryden. Puck hits the side of the net. Savard up for Connor. Chops it out. Here's the chance for Risebrow. Going over the line. Burner with Pat Hughes. Pat Hughes' pass comes to the other side. Robinson couldn't keep it in. And Serge Savard gives it to Robinson. Over to Doug Risebrow. And he shoots it over the line. A shot back out again. Now then Robinson. Over the line. Robinson. Getting set, set it through. At the Canadian player, Rick Chartra, couldn't get a handle on the puck. Now it's Sittler, he was checked. Savard to Robinson, over to Risebrow. Risebrow just puts it in. That's going over the red line, and we touched, and we have another face-off for Ison.
Leafs have gone 19 games without a victory over Montreal, dating back to November 17th, 1976. And again, for late tuners in, Mike Palmateer was taken to hospital today. Had a minor operation on his arm to relieve some pressure in there on the muscle. He was in great pain last night during the latter stages of this hockey game.
Yes, it's a wonder he was able to continue when you figure he was hurt in the second period and he had to go into the second overtime.
Now I know why Scotty stays so cool all the time. He keeps chewing on ice all night.
Thought he had a swollen jaw.
Puck goes to Larry Robinson. Comes back to the blue line. Hutchinson kept it in with a shot.
A little delayed reaction there, but it went in.
Rocky Saginuk, I believe, tipped it in.
The whistle would have gone in another second, so they scored just in time. It's 4-1 now. The Leafs finally get one past Dryden here in this hockey game.
Well, Hutch just lays it out in front of the net. Leafs had two men right in front. They keep whacking at it, and Saginuk knocks it in the net. And Gardner, one good thing about it, Myers was in great position. You know, he was on that side of the net.
Hutchison and Gardner will probably draw assists. I think it was Gardner's deflection that steered the puck into Dryden.
Saginuk. Assist number 23, Dave Hutchison, and number 18, Paul Gardner. Time 14:46. Rocky Saginuk from Dave Hutchison and Paul Gardner. Time 14:46.
That makes it a 4-1 hockey game as it's back in Canadian territory. Around on the boards. It comes, and Lambert trying to get it loose. Gardner fights for it. Gardner comes up with it. Shoots the puck into the corner. And it's Guy Lafleur flipping it up into the crowd as he tried to get away from Tiger Williams.
Well, the Leafs are still working. You know, you have to give them credit there. Each guy is working as hard as he can.
Well, Gary, if they could get another one here before this period comes to an end, it would really give them a little zip.
Make it very interesting, Brian.
The puck in the faceoff circle comes back to Burrows. A shot in front. Gardner was knocked down. And there's going to be a cross-checking penalty handed out. And coming off the ice is Brian Engblom. Live from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto, the Stanley Cup playoffs.
You too. Let's see if we can catch it.
Well, Engblom was clearing the front of the net. And I guess they could have called that interference, cross-checking. Great opportunity.
Mario Salving with the puck. Gets it over to Ian Turnbull. Leafs for the man advantage. Lining it down the and that one. Seemed to hit Pat Boutet, another shot, Fittler's shot. And that one was stopped from point-blank range. Boy, the Leafs are now putting on the pressure.
You know, it was Boutet, I think, who got in front of that first shot. May have given a little bit of an assist to Dryden on the play as Scotty Bowman looks on.
This is the first time tonight, Brian, where the Leafs had put a little pressure on them, you know, where they had two or three good chances to put one by Dryden. You know,
the crowd senses it, too. Take a look at it again. There's Boutet getting all tangled up with Dryden. Here's the second try by Sittler.
Robinson stopped the last one.
All set to go as Lemire is out there. Lanny McDonald passing it to Boutet. It comes to Sir Savard, and Savard carries to the line, but not out. Turnbull kept it in, knocking it to Pat Boutet to Lanny McDonald. Lanny McDonald back to Turnbull. There's his shot, high and wide. Keep the puck in. Finally, it's Sir Savard rolling it out, and Lemire missed it. Ian Turnbull comes back over the line to Sittler. Darryl Sittler from the side. Roll it right in front of Pat Boutet.
There's the second one they were looking for on the power play. Sittler, who missed moments earlier when Robinson blocked his shot, got it upstairs on Dryden, and now it's 4-2, and things are really getting heated up here.
All right, don't go away. We've got something going here. Good individual effort here on the power play. Sittler picks up that loose puck, beats Dryden high. He didn't even see it.
Who Tet had a chance. That was blocked. Settler got the rebound and put it upstairs.
I never got through that opening, but the Leafs are back into it, and now you look at a key situation where that next goal.
It's the fifth goal of the playoffs for Settler and his third against Montreal. Time to look at it again. Maybe we'll see it from this angle a little more clearly. There's Savard. He can't corral it. Through traffic behind Dryden.
Now we have a 4-2 hockey game with 3:54 remaining in the second period.
Crowd even has come alive now.
Oh boy.
Now it's Gila Point. Long pass up for Lambert. Lambert knocks it over the line. Hutchison goes down. Puck comes loose to Sittler. Sittler is checked. Lambert goes after it. Harrison cleared it into the corner. Pat Hughes is there. And then John Anderson took it away from him. Up to Lanny McDonald for Darryl Sittler. And it goes to Lanny McDonald, who gets it back to Hutchison. Over onto the... cleared by Robinson. Then Risebrough is watched by Anderson. He's checked. And the puck comes out. Dave Hutchison has it at center. Trying to get it over the line. And it's called offside at the blue line.
Let's go downstairs now to Dave Hodge.
In our second intermission, a film profile of Walter McKechnie of the Leafs, Gary Dornhofer and Bob Golden will talk about a subject that they're very familiar with. Playing in the so-called trenches in front of the net. And Howie Meeker will have highlights of the second period.
I look forward to that profile on Walt McKechnie, who's really been a standout for the Leafs this year. And of course, I'm always interested in what you're going to say to Bob Golden, Gary.
Well, you're going to get the view of what I try to do or what a player does in front of the net, and then what a defenseman tries to do to get him out of there. So Bob should have some interesting comments.
Goes back to Dave Burrows. Burrows clears the puck in and the point. Steering it around the other side and went over Ellis's stick. Cleared by Lemaire, trying to hit Lafleur. Now the point up to Lafleur. Lafleur takes his shot and Harrison stopped that. McKechnie gets it back to Selman. Selman shot it off the boards but not out. Lemaire drove it back in again and Burrows makes sure to Maloney. Maloney to McKechnie. Over the line with Ellis. Trying to steer it through. Burrows knocked it the rest of the way. Engblom gets it around and down the ice, and Borya Salman left to the back and get it. We have 2:25 to go in the second period. 4-2, Montreal leading. Pass to Dan Maloney, goes back to Salman. Stopped in by Mondu, a shot. Harrison stopped that. Lafleur goes after Burrows, but Burrows pulls away from him. Up at center. And that's Lemaire trying to cover Ellis. McKechnie's pass over to Burrows. Burrows drives it to the line, and the Canadians just shoot it out. Going after it was Risebrough. Now over the line for Lemaire. He took a shot off Salming. Back to Borya Salming. His long pass going down the ice. Risebrough gets it up, and a pass ahead to Risebrough. Risebrough. Still with the puck, gets it over the line, and his pass is too far for Chartrand. Williams down the left wing. And Gainey to Savard to Larry Robinson. Off the boards and out to center ice. Quenneville then brings it back over the line. Chartrand had him covered, but Stevens up the Gardner. Puck ends up behind the net. Into the corner for Paul Gardner again. And he gets it out in front. Three Canadians break away. Up at center ice. Over the line. Pass to Risebrough. Risebrough is knocked down. Chartrand's got the puck. Chartrand pass over the backhand. And that's way wide of the net. After to Chartrand. Williams had him covered. Now then Turnbull. Clears it around on the boards for Saginac. Hockey Saginac with 43 seconds. Trying to get away at center. The rebound goes all the way to center ice. 33 seconds left. The puck goes in high, caught by Dryden. Off the boards, Pat Hughes knocks it out. cleared over to Quenville. Quenville lost it, and Quenville knocked down Bob Genie as Burroughs shoots the puck over for Anderson. Pass to Gardner, and it's offside. Back inside the Leaf blue line.
That was definitely offside. The Canadians were complaining about an offside play last night, or one they thought was offside that paid off in a Toronto goal. Now we're down to 13 seconds, and this period started tamely enough, but we've had quite a finish now as the Leafs click for two goals, first Saganuk and then Sittler on the power play. So it's 4-2 now. Montreal in front, 13 seconds to play, second period.
Darryl Sittler with Lanny McDonald and John Anderson. Gets it back to Burroughs. Burroughs had it hit a stick. Now it comes out to center ice. Engblom, the wrong shot. Harrison stops that. Goes over to Anderson. Anderson gets rid of it. And there goes the bell to end the second period. And the two teams are getting set now to leave the ice. For Toronto 2. And the summary of that second period, Mondu 8:06, Hughes at 10:31, Saganuk at 14:46, Sittler at 16:06, and the shots on goal, Montreal 14, Toronto 11.
Well, I think that the fans here are really going to get in the spirit of things, and the players will respond. You know, they got two goals late in the period, and I'm sure they had a lot of enthusiasm in the dressing room, and you know, the guys are saying, come on, we can get going here. You know, we're only two behind, not four.
And what will the Montreal players be saying in that intermission?
Well, they had a letdown. There's no question about it. They had the 4-0 lead. They thought they had the game in the bag, and they started playing very loosey-goosey, and they've got to get things going now.
Rangers leading your Philadelphia Flyers 4-0 in the second. Boston over Pittsburgh 2-1 in the second.
Play underway, and we're all the way down into Montreal territory where Larry Robinson has the puck. Off the boards to Rick Chartrand. Chartrand gets it over to Bob Gainey. He's poked checked by Borya Selman. Lanny McDonald is checked. Selman comes back through center. A long shot. Dryden stopped that. Here's another try and another stop by Dryden. As the Leafs start to open up with the artillery.
You know, it's very important when you come out of that dressing room that the first shift that you have sets the tempo of that period. And the Leafs got into that zone and had two good shots. All right, you're going to see the blast by Salming from the point. Dryden never had any trouble with it, but they got the puck in there and they're putting on some pressure.
Canadians get the draw and it's Serge Savard. Over on the far side to Bob Gainey, then cleared by Risebrow up to center ice. Now the Leafs come back. Burroughs shooting the puck in. Off the boards, Larry Robinson. Robinson, a cleared pass. Cleared by Chartrand to Risebrow, and he just elects to dump it into the corner. Mike Gainey went behind the net, and it was picked off by Salming. Salming's pass for Anderson is going the length of the ice. Going back to get it is Serge Savard, and it's whistled down for icing.
Well, if a fifth game in this series is necessary, it'll be played in Montreal Tuesday night, and we'll bring you that action from the Forum. If Montreal should win tonight, then we'll bring you the game New York Rangers at Philadelphia Tuesday night, 8 o'clock start Eastern time.
Jacques Lemaire out there with Guy Lafleur and Yvonne Lambert. Leafs win the draw. McKechnie, a long pass for Ellis, and he couldn't control it. Wendell had it go off his stick. Here's a pass to Lemaire, and a call back on the offside. Jacques Lemaire, number 25, Montreal Canadiens.
Out in Winnipeg today, the Quebec St. Foy midget team won the Air Canada tournament, the Midget Championship of Canada, by defeating Ontario's St. Michael's College, 9-7 in overtime.
A long pass. Here's Lemaire getting into the clear. Going in alone. Shoots. And Harrison made a save. Lemaire tried to get it out in front again. As Paul Harrison made the save. Now it goes over to Ellis. Back to Turnbull. Turnbull coming down. Takes his shot. It was weak. And it's gloved by Dryden and held under.
Oh, that was a big save by Harrison. His best save, I would say, of this hockey game.
Well, that's what you need.
Brian. You know, had Montreal scored there, it would have been a difficult task, but Harrison certainly came up big, and, you know, a situation like that has to get the guys going.
He had to be quick on that rebound. Lemaire appeared to be out of the play after taking the initial shot, then he batted at the puck, and that very nearly trickled through the pads of Harrison, but a big save. Mark Napier injured last night, watching on. He had a big game last night for Montreal.
Montreal 4, Toronto 2. Leafs have the puck. Saginaw a shot. Brighton sucks for Williams. It's cleared over to Guy Lafoit. A long shot out at center. Gardner, who went to get a new stick, shoots it back out to center ice. Now Saginaw is checked. It's Jacques Lemaire. Lemaire covered by Gardner, and the puck goes into Leafs territory. Ends up behind the net. And it's Roy Salmon. Salmon with Hutchison. Up to Williams. Williams shot. Knocked down by Saginaw. Here's the shot. It's the open side of the net. Passed out in front again. Saginaw with a backhand. Gardner comes in. Julius Elming a shot. And Guy Lafleur comes back. He gives it to Lambert. To Lafleur. Lafleur shoots. Oh, he shot it wide. Back for Robinson. Then to Mondu to Lafleur. And he's changing on the goal. Williams shoots the puck in. Larry Robinson gets it. Off the boards and down the ice. Pat Hughes couldn't touch it. Salming will, and we have enough. From Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto, this is Stanley Cup 79. Ready for the faceoff now with 8 minutes, 1 second to go in regulation time. 4-2 Montreal. Up for Risebrow, over the line, Chartrand. He was knocked down by Turnbull. Tiger Williams back to the net. Williams leaving it for Turnbull. Gets it up to Gardner. Gardner, a pass for Saginaw, then went by him, and Robinson knocked it back out to center ice. Turnbull, a pass over for Williams. Williams shot it in. Savard knocks it down. Savard missed the body check, trying to get away from Gardner. Did a spin around, and he got it out over the blue line. Rocky Saginaw, covered by Bob Gainey. Gardner shoots the puck into the corner. Out of the net comes Wright. Gets it over on the right side of Chartrand. Tried to get it ahead for Risebrow, and Quenneville shoots it right back, stopped by Savard. And Savard shoots it down the ice. Going over the red line, Turnbull will touch it, and we have an ice.
6:58 to play. Gary, here's a cute father and son shot. Darryl Sittler and Ryan Sittler, age 5, wears 27, the Sittler name on the back, and he's a pretty good skater for a 5-year-old.
What a future Ryan has in store for him.
He's a cute kid, and Darryl's writing a book on goal scoring, and Ryan looks like he might be quite a goal scorer as he comes along in hockey.
Well, I see him here, you know, during the Leafs practices prior to the day of a game. He's out there filling the net.
And he says Pat Boutette knocks him down, won't let him get up.
Walt McKechnie with Maloney and Lanny McDonald. The puck goes to Borya Salming. His backhand taken by Engblom. Over on the left side, the Leafs try to keep it in. They lose it. Here are the Canadians. The pass to Lafleur. Over the line, Lafleur with a shot. Harrison stopped that. McKechnie to Dan Maloney. And Maloney's shot. Knocked down, gets it again. Goes to the corner, right to Walt McKechnie. Score!
That brings them a little closer as the Leafs get their third goal.
Well, for the last 6 or 7 minutes, the Leafs have been continually in the Montreal zone. They've taken the play away from them. Finally, McKechnie.
They're all crowded around Dryden. Dryden has no room at all in there. You heard McKechnie during the intermission say how happy he was to be a member of this Leaf club this year. It gave new life in hockey, and he's been an integral part of this club. McKechnie gets his fourth playoff goal.
Maloney put it right on McKechnie's stick, and he beat Dryden to the glove side. You ever see it again? Spins around. McKechnie shoots it up right past Dryden. Within one. Now it should get very interesting. Montreal just couldn't get that killer instinct, you know, that goal that would put them over the hump, and they've allowed Toronto to come back and
their chances to get a bigger margin. Now it's 4-3 with 6:31 on the clock.
They underway as Robinson's pass. Borjasalmi, McKechnie. McKechnie for Maloney. Guiding out of the net, stops it. Planted it right to Walt McKechnie. McKechnie centered it. And the Canadians shot the puck out to center ice. Cleared back by Hutchison. A long shot. And guiding to Larry Robinson. And another shot, knocked down. Nice serves the ball, loses it to Maloney.
Upper corner.
Oh boy, oh boy.
What a game we've got now. 4-4 tie, 6:02 in the clock, two goals in a matter of seconds here for the Leafs. First McKechnie and then Maloney, upper corner.
Brian, it just goes to show you that if you put pressure on a team, even the Montreal Canadian defense can cough up that puck.
They did on that play. I believe it was Lapointe who failed to clear it. Robinson comes over. He couldn't get it. 29 seconds apart. The Leafs score twice.
Dan Maloney. Assist number 11, Walt McKechnie.
And high number shot again. High over Dave right shoulder. You know, he didn't react to that one at all. Looked like he just didn't see it.
Dan Maloney from Walt McKechnie and Dave Hutchison.
Time
13:58.
And we're certainly going to have a barn burner now.
Crowd is standing. Hutchison drew an assist on the goal. There's the fella who put it up into the net. Dan Maloney tied at 4. Just over 6 minutes to play.
You know, the fans have been on Maloney the last two games here. He certainly doesn't have the speed, you know, to keep up with a lot of the Montreal skaters. And consequently, when you don't have that speed, you look so much slower than everybody else. And the tendency is for the fans to get on you. And he certainly has responded with a first setting up McKechnie and then scoring a goal of his own.
Of course, with your speed, you never had that problem.
Oh, yeah, sure.
We have a delay now as the debris is being cleared off the ice.
Live from Maple Leaf Gardens.
His mask is down on the ice right beside his goal crease area. So we have the young lad behind there, and at the other end, at the Leaf bench, rather, Paul Harrison, number 30. A surprise starter tonight due to the surprise hospitalization and surgery on the arm of Mike Palmateer.
You know, Brian, we can go back to the breakaway by Mondu there with a score at 4-2. And
the shot by Lemaire,
right?
He went in alone. And all those goalposts, five of them behind Harrison, at least one behind Dryden.
You just never know in this game. And you have to give the Leafs a lot of credit. You know, when you look at the two teams, there's no way that the Leafs should be this close, and they just fought back and made a real game of it, and a great opportunity to win it.
You got lots to talk about if it goes a couple of periods of overtime tonight.
I thought we exhausted everything last night.
While we're waiting, let's take another look at this goal. Here's where they failed to clear it. That's Lapointe. Just couldn't get it out. It bounced over his stick.
Well, you know, just prior to that, Robinson had fired the puck around the boards, and the Leafs kept it in. So actually, two giveaways there resulted in Toronto tying the score.
Dryden didn't give him much room on that side. He only had an inch or two in which to put it in.
Two seconds remaining in regulation time. We have a 4-4 tie. It was 2-0 Montreal into the first period. 4-2 Montreal into the second. And the Leafs have scored two unanswered goals in this third period to put themselves on even terms. So we have a 4-4 tie. All set to go. The puck is dropped. That center ice cleared by the Canadians into Leaf territory. Salming and Harrison get mixed up. It's back of the net. Dan Salming over on the wing for Lanny McDonald. He's checked. As Guiney tried to get it. It's picked off by Borja Salming. Up for Lanny McDonald. Lemaire is there. Lemaire drives it back. It bounces out in front. Dan Salming gets it out to center ice. Canadians clear it back in again. Gila Fleur goes after it. And we have 5 minutes and 27 seconds. Now 25 as they get a whistle.
You know, Brian, Montreal has been laying back almost the whole period and allowed Toronto to tie it. Now let's see if they go on the offensive here and,
and try to regain the play.
Well, they've got the personnel out there to do just that with Lemaire at center. Of course, Guy Lafleur on the right side. Burrows has done a fine job on Lafleur and the other Montreal forwards tonight. One-on-one, again, being so tough to get around.
You know what he does a lot, though? Lafleur, he'll carry that puck. As soon as he hits the blue line, he'll make that little swing just inside the blue line and then try to hit that open man.
4-4 tie, 5:25 remaining in regulation time. Heading set for this faceoff, a big one in Leaf territory. Lemaire lost the draw, McKechnie getting it to Turnbull. Ian Turnbull back of the net. Shot it back by Ganey. Ganey tried to get it loose, but Turnbull recovers by smothering the puck.
5:16 in regulation time. Turnbull getting up slowly. On the scoreboard, third period, Rangers leading Philadelphia 4-0. Boston over Pittsburgh 2-1 there in the second. Islanders leading Chicago 1-0 also in the second. Goal by Dennis Potvin, who had 101 points in the regular season.
All set to go, McKechnie, and gets the draw again. Back of the net for Quenneville. Quenneville for Pat Buchet. Pat Buchet down the left wing. A long shot off the boards. Ron Ellis shoots. Dryden stopped that. McKechnie centers it to Pat Buchet, a shot. Oh, and Guy Lapointe just got his skate on that one.
You know, Buchet's in a great position there, but he wants to slap the puck. You know, by the time you draw that stick back and release it, it's a good 3 or 4 seconds, and that allows the block shot.
The slapper hit the leg of Guy Lapointe, and he's trying to shake off the effects of that drive.
You know, it takes a little time to unload that, but if he would just lay a little wrist shot in front of that net, there's always a chance of a rebound, and the Leafs, you know, had somebody in front of the net.
Guy Lapointe is lifting off the ice, as you can see, and his ankle is a little tender on that drive by Pat Buchet. There's Pat Buchet at the bench, and Roger Nielsen. He's really pepping them up. Lanny McDonald talking to the referee.
You know, the Canadians can ill afford to lose any more players. They're pretty soon they'll hold their whole minor league team up. Big face-off.
Harold Sittler with Anderson and McDonald as it's cleared by Savard out the center right. Shot in by Lambert. That's there with a short throw. Lanny McDonald fell down. And I just don't know exactly what happened there.
Myers there, Bill.
Well, that was a very unfortunate thing. The referee watching the play as the Leafs again were a little sloppy in behind and in front of Harrison, and McDonald must have been looking over that way too. And with everybody concentrating on the puck, the referee, McDonald, and one of the Montreal players got all tangled up, and McDonald appears to be injured. He was shaken up last night when he tried to hit Ganey with a check and went into the boards and hit his hip against the boards, but he was able to come back from that.
Tiger's there talking to Myers, telling him to stay out of the way. I think he'll be all right.
Myers was telling me a week or two ago that he sees the day coming when all the officials for added protection will be wearing helmets.
Might be a good idea.
4-4 tie here at the Gardens with 4:44 on the clock.
And Danny McDonald is up, and he seems to be all right. Although I'm sure he'll go and take a rest.
Sort of fella every team loves to have, not only great skills, great talent on the ice, but a team leader in the dressing room, loves to play the game.
Well, we have a lot of fours on the scoreboard. It's a 4-4 tie, and we have 4 minutes and 44 seconds left.
I just said that, Bill.
What's that three doing up there?
Oh, we got a three up there, yep.
Third period.
I'm sure that little scene is a little happier.
Darryl Sittler with Pat Boutette. They're still working on Lanny McDonald, so they'll send Ron Ellis over the boards.
That's Dr. Hastings, the Leaf medical staff, examining the collarbone area of Lanny McDonald.
On the faceoff, Pat Boutette gets it back to Boya Salming. Salming back to the net. Shot it out on the boards to Boutette. Boutette coming at center, a long shot into the corner. Sittler went after it. Robinson just knocks it out to center ice. Salming drives it over on the far wing. Then Guy Lafleur and Rondeau. Rondeau's got the puck closing in. Went too far, was taken out of the play. Two Canadians were knocked out of the play, and there's four Leafs coming back. Boutette back to Turnbull. Turnbull shoots, and he shot it wide. Guy Lafleur coming down the right wing. They're trying to get back. Lemaire getting in. Harrison's got it, and he holds on.
End to end the last few seconds. Turnbull's shot was wide. Lafleur led the return rush. And Harrison grabbed that puck and was able to hang on to it.
You know, it's Lafleur. He's on his backhand. He lays that puck up to Lemaire on his backhand. A lot of players, you know, they can't pass the puck on their backhand, so they'll switch, turn it around so they can, you know, lay that pass up to another player on their forehand. Had he done that, the play would have probably been offside.
Harrison a little steadier as time runs down. 4 minutes even left to play.
In regulation time as we get set to go. Walt McKechnie, Dan Maloney. Been the story of this third period. And back of the net for Dave Burrows. Burrows to Maloney. Maloney. Then to Burrows. Back to McKechnie. Over for John Anderson. Anderson over the line. And it's offside.
Figured very highly in the last two goals, setting one up and then adding the tying goal himself.
Goes back to Engblom. Engblom off the boards down to Quenville. Quenville's pass to McKechnie. He's stopped by Ganey, but Burrows gets it back down and the point has it to Engblom. Off the boards and down into Leafs territory. Quenville can't get it out. Risebrough's pass nowhere near Chartrand. And Dan Maloney, a pass over for Anderson. And trying to center it. Here's a chance for the shot. And that one went just wide of the net. Maloney a shot. That's deflected into the corner. It's cleared out by Ganey. Risebrough gets it back. The point centered it. There's nobody there. And McKechnie has it for the Maple Leafs. A pass over to Quenville. Quenville's pass for Maloney. Goes sliding down the ice. And it's picked off by Guy Lapointe. Over to Engblom. Engblom back at center with Guy Lafleur. Lafleur shoots the puck in. Harrison to Boria Salming. Salming gets it out over the line. 2:43 remaining in regulation time. A 4-4 tie. Sir Savard lost the puck. Taganuk giving it to Williams. A shot. Stopped by Dryden. Ends up in the corner. Down went Gardner. Up the ice for Savard. He chops the puck in. Guy Lafleur and Hutchison go after it. It's Williams. Along the boards. Williams. Still with it. And Guy Lafleur centers it right in front of Robinson. Harrison stopped that. It goes in back to the net. Cleared over here to Williams. Williams ahead to Gardner. Gardner. And he was offside. At the blue line. 1:57 remaining in regulation time.
Williams found himself in a quandary down in the corner. He coughed up the puck to Guy Lafleur, of all people, who fed Robinson, and Harrison again came up with a great stop.
That was a great save.
I think we'll have time to catch it here. This is that shot by Robinson. Shots in the third period. Montreal 7, Toronto 13.
There he is, Paul Harrison and John Anderson. Lanny McDonald is back out with Sittler, Anderson, Salming, and Quenville. Risebrough with Chartrand and Ganey. Puck cleared up to center ice. Flipped in by the Canadians and back forward. Lanny McDonald has it in the corner. Up for John Anderson. Off his stick to Rick Chartrand. Chartrand shot it in. Risebrough's going after it. Paul Harrison came into the net and Solman for John Anderson, and it goes all the way down to the Montreal blue line. Now it's Larry Robinson. Comes out to center ice. Lanny McDonald getting it back to Quenville. The Boya Salming. Salming up for Anderson. Anderson goes down. Salming has the puck. Over to Sittler. Sittler stops. Robinson had him covered. Bob Ganey. A pass over to Ryan Brown. We have less than a minute to go in regulation time. Lanny McDonald. A pass for Sittler to Pat Boutette. Over the line. It's knocked out again. Here comes Lafleur and Mondeau. Here's Lafleur's shot. And that knocked Harrison down. Right, he kept it out. Now it's out for Sittler. Sittler's pass for Ellis. Into the corner. Sittler has it back of the net. To Ellis. Ellis back to Sittler. Sittler tried to get it to Hutchison. He did. Hutchison's backhand ends up behind the net. Into the corner. Pat Boutette. Then to Sittler, right in front of the net. Right for Sittler again, and he goes down. And the Canadians come back with 12 seconds. Raylan, a pass over the line to Larry Robinson. Robinson trying to cut in front. There's a shot. Oh, Paul Harrison.
With 2 seconds to play. What a save. A brilliant save by Harrison. That...
And look at Robinson's down on the ice, too.
Robinson nursing his face. He may have been clipped on that play. A great play by Robinson, a greater play by Harrison, and the Leaf players know it. He's still getting a standing ovation for Paul Harrison. Probably the best save he ever made in his life.
That's incredible. With only 2 seconds left to play.
Watch again. Robinson from the corner. Here he comes. And here comes the shot. Watch the glove. In the glove. Tremendous.
You know, Harrison was out of position there on the Robinson play and still caught up with it. Here's a blast by Lafleur. You think he can't shoot the puck?
Oh. Looking on, Napier and Dougie Jarvis. Jarvis from Brantford, Ontario. I said, you made the town famous, and he suggests, and Wayne Gretzky's making it even more famous.
Face off with 2 seconds remaining in regulation time. We have a 4-4 tie.
Guess what's going to happen again tonight?
Yeah. A lot of folks be late for work tomorrow.
Of course, we got the hour cushion starting at 7.
That helps.
I would like to be here all night. They keep playing like this. Now we're ready to go. The face-off. Jones wins the draw. The bell goes, and we're in overtime. 14-10, and we're in overtime. As the Leafs clear the puck down the ice, it bounces to Dryden, and he holds it with Lanny McDonald right down there on his doorstep. Face-off will be in the Montreal zone to the left. As we have Pat Boutette, Darryl Sittler, Lanny McDonald, Solman, and Dave Burrows. All set to go. Jack Lemaire out there with Guy Lafleur and Bob Ganey. There's Savard and Larry Robinson. Around to Lafleur, hopped by Burrows out to center ice, and it's picked up there by Boutette. Getting it back over to Borya Solman. Solman is chased back. Salming waiting behind the net, not wanting to take any chances. Fleur up there looking for a loose puck, and it deflects into the crowd, and we'll have a face-off.
Brian, I just think that this game is going to end in the first 5 minutes. I just have that feeling that it's not going to go like it did last night.
Just looking over the Leaf record in overtime since 1967 when they won a thriller in three extra periods, I believe it was. They've been involved in 12 overtime games, won only three.
It's Boreas Salming giving it to Dave Burrows. Up it goes for Pat Bouchette. Lemaire stopped it to Savard. Savard to Larry Robinson. Up for Lafleur. He shot the puck into the corner. Salming drives it around the boards again. This time it's Pat Bouchette with the coming down with Lanny McDonald. Super shoot. And that's good by Dryden and knocks into the corner. Lafleur shot it down the ice. And that's going over the red line, and that'll be icing.
One thing about Dryden, you know, he has a habit of, in that sudden death overtime, really coming up with his best save, as we had noted last night.
He looked very good on that last drive. He played it in the classic style, getting in front of the puck and then getting the gloves, the stick, everything in front of it. Roger Nielsen and his counterpart, Scotty Bowman. He's been here many times before.
All set to go now. McKechnie, Maloney, and Ellis. The puck taken by Guy Lapointe, shot it around on the boards. And it's out at center ice. Quinville lost the puck. Kiermaidou tried to get to it. Lambert got it behind the net. Cleared around on the boards. It comes out in front. Mondou a shot, and that just missed. Lambert's got it again for Montreal. Trying to center it. Walt McKechnie. Line with Turnbull to Maloney. And that is slapped right back. The Leafs trying to get out of their own end. Canadians forechecking. A long pass from McKechnie is going down the ice, right on the net. And Dryden gives it to Lindholm. Lindholm along up to Pierre Mondou. Mondou's pass on the right side. Closing in to Pierre Roux. Goes to the blue line. Guy Lapointe trying to keep it in. And it rolls out Maloney and Lapointe there. Outside the blue line.
The important thing for Lapointe on that play was to not let that puck slip behind him, because there were two Leafs in the vicinity waiting for a chance to pounce on it.
Not only that, it was a good play by Maloney to stay right with him, you know, and not skate by him. Had Lapointe been able to control it, you know, two players were already gone.
Brings out Paul Gardner along with Williams and Saginac. Risebrow, Connor, and Pat Hughes. The puck goes over to Burrows, who clears the puck to center ice. There's Savard back at his own blue line. Gardner trying to check him. Savard still has it, then Gardner goes after him again, and Robinson has to take it. Robinson up at center. Hits the shot right on, and juggled and held onto by Paul Hart.
You know, Harrison really isn't the type of goalie that challenges the shooters like Pelletier, but he's a stand-up goalie, and although on that play, he was about a good 10 feet outside his crease area.
Seconds on the ice tonight for Salming.
How did that compare with last night? Do you remember what his final total was for last night?
In all the excitement of that overtime, I didn't get a total, but it was pretty close to that. 34 minutes and 42 seconds, John Shannon tells me, last night.
Boreas Salming back to the net. On the wing to Williams. Williams straight down the left wing. Back down by Chartrand. And it's Risebrow being covered by Gardner. Gardner has the puck. He and Rocky Saginac go to center. Gardner's taken out of the play. Robinson feeds the pass for Risebrow to Larry Robinson. Williams took Robinson into the boards.
Well, I'll tell you, that's a gutsy call by Bob Myers, dude. You know, anytime you're in sudden death overtime, very rarely do they call a penalty.
Two minutes look at it sticking. Time 2:38. Dave Williams.
2:38 into the overtime. Williams is called for high sticking. The crowd doesn't like it. As you said, a gutsy call by Myers. Tradition has it that there are very, very few penalties called unless they're blatant.
Well, the Leafs certainly are going to have their work cut out for them now with this potent Montreal power play. And I think the Canadians realize what an opportunity to end it all right here.
The fat is in the fire for the Toronto Maple Leafs now. They're playing shorthanded. And let's see, it's Robinson, Lemaire, Lambert.
You know, it looks like they're going to put Robinson up on the forward line here, Bill. And you know where he's going to go.
He's going where you went, right in front of that net. Well, the Leafs in trouble here in overtime. Sudden death. One goal ends it. Lemaire to Robinson. He's right in front of the net. And he was knocked down before he could get a shot. Jerry Butler in the corner. Lost it to Lambert. Here's the deal, the point, the shot. That's knocked down. Lapointe's got it again. Lapointe having trouble. Gets it to Lemaire. Lemaire back to Lapointe. Back to Lemaire. Lemaire closes in. Shoots. Harrison stopped that. And it ends up in the corner. Comes over here to Lafleur. Here comes his shot. That's knocked down. And it's driven down the ice. Lafleur has to go back for it. Leafs shorthanded. 1:19 left in the penalty. Up the ice for Guy Lapointe to Larry Robinson. Drives the puck in. Off the board. Boreas Ullman can't get it out. Guy Lafleur shot it into the corner. Turnbull then drives one off the glass and down the ice. Dryden gets it over to Lafleur. 56 seconds remaining in the penalty to Williams. Back of the net, Lapointe. Lapointe up to Robinson, up at center ice. A pass to Lemaire, he's checked. And it's shot back out again, and there's 42 seconds left in the penalty. Back for Pat Hughes in Montreal. Hughes getting it up at center ice. Lapointe over the line. Lapointe stops, trying to set it up to Robinson. Robinson waits. Canadians getting set. Here comes the shot.
Season is over. The Canadians win it at 4:14 of overtime with Williams in the penalty box. The Leafs are furious with the official, and they're holding a couple of players back now for that call against Williams. The Canadians, meanwhile, are congratulating their big man, Larry Robinson, who drilled one from just inside the blue line, a power play goal at 4:14, and for the second night in a row, the Leafs have seen their efforts come to no avail as the Canadians sweep the series in four straight, and Tiger Williams is still in a fury and trying to get at the official, Bob Myers. Maloney has pulled Williams to the ice. Robinson is over there with him.
I see Robinson's trying to quiet him down.
4:14, the goal by Robinson from Lapointe. And Pat Hughes at 4:14.
Well, Brian, let's give the Leafs a lot of credit. You know, they certainly weren't favored to win this series, but they gave it a gutsy try. Every single Leaf they put out, and they worked as hard as they could. But look at the Montreal lineup, a lot of firepower, and they had about four regulars not in the lineup, and they just keep coming up with these great players. But it certainly was two great hockey games that we witnessed here.
Well, you do give the Leafs a lot of credit for digging deep and coming back in this game tonight after trailing by four, and it appeared to be that they were all through for the season, but they fought back gamely. Then it took a clutch goal in overtime by Larry Robinson to finish their season. Robinson, a tremendous sportsman, a tremendous hockey player. There with Darryl Sittler, that's quite a picture. A great deal of respect showing there. We know, the faces.
Brian, the teams, they bumped and they grinded out for four games, and everybody was hitting. And then they can shake hands at the end and congratulate. That's really great to see.
But it was a hard-fought series.
And so the final score was Montreal 5 and Toronto 4.